Now, in addition to the standard products generated by the pipelines, we have, if you participated in the session yesterday, we have the so-called user-provided data products, UPDPs. So these are products delivered by Herschel key programs. So up to now, we have about 14 such key programs delivering their SPIRE photometry maps. The UPDPs can be downloaded as a whole or on an offset per offset basis. Eva showed yesterday how you can do that. Some teams also store UPDPs in dedicated repositories outside the Herschel Science Center and outside the Herschel Archive. They have dedicated databases and allow also for browsing and doing some additional things. And it also, some UPDPs are made available through the IPAC ESA interface. So you have to always to keep in mind that the UPDPs are generated throughout the Herschel mission, and some of the UPDPs are with very old versions of HYPE, of Herschel Processing Environment, Interactive and Processing Environment. So in some cases, the final version in the archive now is actually much better than some of the UPDPs that are provided by the key programs. So you have to read very carefully their release notes and or papers, so that you have actually an idea what they used and how they produced these products. On top of the user-provided data products, we also have the highly processed data products, which are expert-processed data. They are served in similar fashion as the UPDP, so they will be provided by an offside D per offside D basis, or they can be also downloaded as a whole. For the photometer, we currently see very few HPDPs. One of them is the level 3 large map of the galactic plane. It's a huge map. It's very difficult to produce by normal users because it needs a huge amount of memory. And it is very difficult to make it available in the standard way because it's a very big file. I don't know how many gigabytes. So that's why we will process it and provide it as a highly processed data product into small chunks via this HPDP interface. Another HPDP is the SPIRE Point Source Catalog, which is currently in the validation phase. It also will be provided per offside D basis, and it's a blind detection for the three SPIRE bands. So there is one catalog. There will be separate catalogs for each of the three bands. And there are some tentative HPDPs which depend on manpower, which is to fix some maps that show residual striping, like the view graph that is shown here. It's important to know that this residual striping is really very low contrast, so it's of the order of 5%, no more than that, and it's visible for very deep observations of deep extragalactic fields. And there are some 200 maps affected by this residual striping out of about 7,000. We will see, depending on the manpower, if we can really provide expert processing of those maps so that we remove the striping. In the next session, I will show one example of this. And we have another products and the ancillary data products, which are not necessarily associated with an observation. They are preservation storage of items that are needed for users of Herschel SPIRE data, but also they have some information about, could have some information about future missions like health monitoring or engineering-oriented items. So for the SPIRE photometer, we see the following list of ancillary data products. Calibration files, calibration models, Neptune, which is our primary calibrator, and other planets and asteroid models. Also the beam maps, the filter relative spectral response functions, and the aperture efficiencies. Some of these are available in the SPIRE calibration context, so you can download it from the Herschel Science Archive, but providing those as separate files is also quite useful for archive users. We will also store some software there, the onboard software images and release notes. These are mainly engineering stuff. The uplink products like mission database, engineering trend analysis and health monitoring, and some historical telemetry and science data from pre-launch test campaigns. So to finish with the products on top of the standard products that we will provide, here is the table that shows the timeline when we will make available some of the highly processed data products and ancillary data products. So the SPIRE Point Source Catalog will be made available maybe December or early in January 2017. A similar timescale for the level 3 map of the galactic plane, and the maps with striping, with residual striping, will probably be provided spring 2017, depending on manpower. For the ancillary data products, those files that are already available in the SPIRE calibration products are also already available as ancillary data products, like the beam maps and beam profiles, the filter transmission curves, Neptune, and other calibration models. While the engineering files for trend analysis and health monitoring or software and applic products will be made available at the end of the year. So,
before you move on, I have a question from one of the participants.
Okay.
Is the following. Is a high-pass filter necessary for SPIRE photometry data reduction for point-like sources with DEP integration times, like 1-2 hours in a small area?
Okay, so this is more on data processing, data analysis topic, which will be covered in the next session. Although I haven't covered this particular topic, if a high-pass filtering is necessary or not. So for point source calibrated map, you don't really need high-pass filtering, except if you are interested in point sources and you have a lot of serious emission or extended emission that you want to get rid of. The only, well, one way to deal with this is to go back to the timelines and apply this high-pass filtering so that you remove all extended emission, you end up with the point sources.